We're given the graph of a quadratic function and asked to find many of the key characteristics about the function. The first thing we should notice right away is that the parabola opens downward, and therefore we have a high point, which should be the vertex of the parabola. So this point here would be the vertex of the parabola. Notice how it has coordinates 2, comma 4. Let's go ahead and record that over here on the right. This is also the only point that's on the parabola and also on the axis of symmetry, which would be this vertical line here with an equation of x equals 2. The parabola is symmetrical across this line, or we can think of if we folded the graph across this vertical line, the two halves would match up perfectly. And now that we've already found the vertex, let's find the maximum or minimum function value. Again, because this is a high point, the maximum value occurs at this point. The maximum value would be the y-coordinate of the vertex. So we have a maximum of 4, and we would say it occurs at x equals 2. So the location is the x value, and the maximum value is the y value. Now let's go back up to the beginning and find the domain and the range. The domain is a set of all possible inputs or x values, and because the graph moves left and right forever without any holes or breaks, if we were to project this graph onto the x-axis, notice how the domain would be all real numbers. It goes to the right forever and to the left forever. So we can say, using interval notation, the domain would be from negative infinity to positive infinity. Or using inequalities, we could say x is greater than negative infinity and less than positive infinity. The range is a set of all possible y values. Y values occur along the vertical axis of the y-axis. And notice how the largest y value would be the y value of the vertex, which is 4. So if we project this onto the y-axis, it would be from negative infinity all the way to positive 4. So the range, using interval notation, would be the interval from negative infinity to positive 4, but the interval is closed on 4 because 4 is included in the range. Or using inequalities, we would say y is less than or equal to positive 4. Now we want to determine when the function is increasing and decreasing. One way to think of this is if we were to walk from left to right on the graph, if we're walking uphill, the function is increasing. If we're walking downhill, the function is decreasing. Or more formally, if as x increases, y increases, the function is increasing, and as x increases, if y decreases, the function is decreasing. And notice how the graph changes from increasing to decreasing at the vertex. So the function would be increasing on this interval and decreasing on this interval. And at x equals 2, it's neither increasing or decreasing, so we won't include 2 on either interval. So on the open interval from negative infinity to 2, the function is increasing, and on the open interval from 2 to infinity, the function is decreasing. So using interval notation, we would say it's increasing on the open interval from negative infinity to 2, or we could say when x is less than 2, and it's decreasing on the open interval from 2 to infinity, or we could say when x is greater than 2. And now for the last part, we want to find the x and y intercepts of the graph. The x intercepts are where the graph crosses the x axis. Notice how it crosses the x axis here and here. So the x intercepts are negative 2, 0, and 6, 0. The y-intercept is where the graph crosses the y-axis, which occurs here at the point 0, 3. I hope you found this helpful.